Alrighty, so we have some interesting news coming out of Canada's Wonderland, and it is really weird because of the timing. They just announced UConn Striker for the 2019 season, and we are now starting to see what looks like. Again, please take this as mere speculation, but it looks like some weird activity next to Mindbuster that would suggest several things, possibly. So we've been seeing weird activity for quite some time now. But it looks like, as of today, construction equipment has arrived next to Mindbuster. Not only has construction equipment arrived next to Mindbuster, construction trailers. And not just one, but two. In fact, there are three if you include the electrical company, Hartwell, along with that. There's also weird objects like little wagons, a massive wagon actually, weird. I don't know what it would be used for, right there off in the distance. And we also know that there was some weird water work taking place next to Mindbuster. So this raises a lot of questions. In fact, it raises more questions than answers, even with this video. This video is for mere speculation purposes alone, and I want to hear from you guys down below what you think is going on. So as you can see, we have three construction trailers. The Hartwell one is the electrical company off in the distance, and the two here, we have no idea who they're for. We know that Mindbuster has been extremely painful lately, and a lot of people have been calling for an RMC. Now, when you question the park at media events about an RMC, they play it off like it's not in their future. Now, you can never trust what a park official says about future attractions, because a lot of the time, they're just going to pull your leg. So there's several things that could be going on with Mindbuster. So we know that Frontier Canada has moved into the Yukon Striker area, and more to be announced, Frontier Canada. There is more to be announced about Frontier Canada coming soon. Not all the details have been revealed. So I'm going to go over some of the possible things that could be happening with Mindbuster and Frontier Canada, and why Mindbuster is such an important part of it. So for those of you that understand Frontier Canada and when Canada's Wonderland first opened and its plans, know that Mindbuster was supposed to be the main attraction. Well, UConn Striker has stolen the spotlight, and in my opinion, nothing can really take that back. So one might think, are they really going to RMC Mindbuster this soon after UConn Striker? Well, there is a possibility, but I don't quite think that's the answer. I honestly think there's more going on here. You could go as far down as saying they're just going to add some tunnels and theming to this and make it more of like a Frontier Canada themed wooden coaster. There is scaffolding there, so I mean, it could be anything. Or are they going to RMC it? Yeah, there's a chance of that, but we don't see any solid evidence of that quite yet. Now, maybe they're just going to come in and retrack the entire ride. That's a big possibility. We did see some very minor work going on in the off-season, and the stickers were removed from the front of Mindbuster as well. So it's almost like a no-named coaster if you look at it without the sign up front. Now, there are several other possibilities. Maybe Mindbuster is going to be bulldozed for a Splashworks expansion. We know Splashworks is crazy busy this season. It cannot handle its current demand, and they need a much larger water park at Canada's Wonderland. We know that 2020 may actually bring either a kids expansion or a water park expansion, or maybe it's going to bring an RMC. Who knows at this point with all this weird activity? So I'm honestly confuzzled even more than I was before. But CoasterNet brought up a very good thing, a very weird thing, in fact, with this kind of like blog post from Canada's Wonderland on their website. In fact, all credit goes to CoasterNet because I completely missed this, but there is definitely references on this little kind of like, I guess, homage to like the old Frontier Canada, but also a slight teaser. And we're going to analyze that in just a second. But again, I want to hear from you guys down below. What do you think is going on with Mindbuster? Do you think this is going to be an RMC attraction for 2020 or 2021? Or do you think it's going to be a retrack of the complete coaster for 2020 or even 2019? Or do you think they're just going to add some theming to the coaster to help it blend in with Frontier Canada a little more? And by theming, I mean like mining tunnels or something like that added to the coaster. Now, here is that poster that CoasterNet showed in their video. So definitely go check out CoasterNet's video as they talk about an RMC coming to Canada's Wonderland, well, the possibilities of it. But I'm actually looking at something quite different. This poster to me, if you look at the gun, suggests or hints at possibly the removal of Soloco. This is interesting because we know that Cedar Point just removed Witch's Wheel, and ours has been kind of like iffy in the past couple years, so this would make sense if it was removed. It's also right in the area of Mindbuster and plays an interesting part. You also have the five aces, and CoasterNet points out the five aces in reference to, you know, Maverick and Steel Vengeance and that whole teasing campaign before Steel Vengeance was built. This might be just to throw us off, a red herring, or maybe even a possible hint to an RMC coming to Canada's Wonderland. It's all pure speculation, and no one knows until something RMC arrives on site. With all the weird activity going on at Mindbuster, we still don't have the solid proof of an RMC coming to Canada's Wonderland, but one can't ignore all that weird activity going on. It's actually really interesting. So not only do we have the three construction trailers that are now directly near Mindbuster, you have weird activity like lumber, scaffolding, and rebar cages, or the rebar themselves that are turned into rebar cages. And then you have like the weird cherry picker and a weird type wagon, or kind of like, I guess like a storage, like it's not quite a flatbed truck. It's more like a wagon. It's really weird. I don't know how to describe it, but you have really weird objects going on around Mindbuster. And then you see a lot of crew or whoever they are, maintenance workers, standing underneath Mindbuster watching it a lot. So it's quite interesting. Is Mindbuster at the end of its life? Is it beyond repair and it's home to a very valuable Splashworks expansion? Or is it home to a very valuable RMC for the Frontier Canada? There are five ace cards, and I honestly think, especially from hearing at the media event for Yukon Striker, we know that Frontier Canada is a five-year expansion plan, or we are assuming it's a five-year expansion plan based off of things we heard. Five cards, 5 years, five attractions. So we had the, if you want to look at it, you had the two attractions, Lumberjack and Flying Canoes, added to last year in 2018. You have Yukon Striker added in 2019. And you have two more attractions that could potentially be added to Frontier Canada to complete it off. Maybe a railroad and a RMC, or maybe an RMC and a flat ride. Who knows? The five aces to me suggest nothing more than five attractions or 5 years. We know that Frontier Canada is a five-year expansion plan based off of like things we heard at the media event and things that have been discussed, and it would make sense. Usually when things are being built or planned, it's a five-year plan. So I want to hear from you guys. What do you think of this? Do you agree with me? The five aces mean 5 years or five attractions? And do you think Sol Loco is on the chopping block as suggested by the gun pointing down at it? And what do you think's going on with Mindbuster? I have no clue. I'm going off of what I'm seeing in front of me. And again, thank you so much to Thrill Spirits from Instagram for sending me some of this footage used in this video today. Thanks so much, guys. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for more to enjoy. Thanks so much, guys. Bye.